Hey there, my name is Drew Brashler, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to use the Yamaha DM3 with Waves SuperRack Performer and how to get the left-right bus through Waves for some left-right bus processing for your Yamaha DM3. Now, if you're brand new to my channel, I'm all about helping you feel more confident in your production gear no matter where you're starting from. Also, if you are on a path to learn more about audio engineering, I have a weekly newsletter where I share some of my favorite tips and tricks straight to your inbox for free. And you can sign up for that over at audiotoolkit.co. So head over there, sign up, it's free, and then you will get some of my favorite tips and tricks into your email every week. But let's actually go ahead and dive in on the Yamaha DM3 and see how to get this thing working with Waves SuperRack Performer. Now, the Yamaha DM3 and the Yamaha DM3-D both have a USB connection on the back of the console that gives you 18 in and 18 out over a USB 2.0 cable. So you just need the printer style cable, and then you can convert that into whatever your computer accepts where you have your Waves SuperRack Performer installed, and then you just plug it into the USB host on the back of the console and into your computer and start up Waves. Now, this USB is sent in our patch bay. So if we go and click into our patch bay, we can see that our output of our USBs right here are already by default set to the inputs on the back of the board. So that's input 1 through 16 would be by default 1 through 16 on the USB. And then 17 and 18 is an output of the stereo left right fader. So if you are using some Dante channels, you will need to go ahead and route some of those Dante channels to your USB to have Waves actually accept it. Now, when we are setting this up, we need to set our gains of our local inputs before we start working with Waves back into the console. So we have our microphone here, and this is plugged into input 1. So I have my channel here, and we have my gain up here. So we see this, and we can hear this in our ears. So check, check, check. Now, this is being sent out the USB because it is right at the preamp. There is no insert for the DM3. So we do have to work as if we are patching an input to the USB, have the USB go to Waves, through Waves, come back into the console, and then our channel would then change to be from USB. So instead of being in one, it would be USB 1. But there's a few things that we need to set up before we can do that. So first things I'm going to do is look at my word clock and see what my sample rate is at. And I still have this set at 48 kilohertz from my video that I was doing about how to connect to a TO. And so I'm just going to leave this at 48 kilohertz for now. And so I will X out of that. Next thing I'm going to do is go over to my computer where I have Waves SuperRack Performer installed. And we have Waves SuperRack Performer right here. And I'm going to go into setup, and I'm going to go to device and select my Yamaha DM3. And once I do that, it's going to automatically select the sample rate the DM3 is running. And so if you're at 96K, it is going to be running at 96K on your computer. If you're at 48, it's going to be running at 48 kilohertz on your computer. We can then select a buffer size. And so the lower the buffer size, the higher the CPU load and the less latency. The higher the buffer size or the bigger number there is, the longer amount of latency that you're going to have on Waves and the less processor load you're going to have through your computer. So a lower buffer is less latent, but a higher task on the processor. A bigger buffer is longer latency, but less task for the processor. So if you have an older computer, you might need to go and select a bigger buffer size. If you have a brand new computer, you might be able to get close to that 32 of a buffer size. Now, when I'm running this, I'm typically at 128, and I find that that is a good leeway between the two of them. But since I'm also doing a recording on my computer with the screen recording, I am going to leave it on 256 for now. So once we have that set, we can go into overview. And this is where we have our racks for Waves SuperRack Performer. And so what we want to do is we want to go ahead and assign our racks to how we have our channels laid out. So for instance, this vocal microphone is sitting on input one. And so what I'll do is I'll go select mono, Yamaha DM3, channel one. But say I have a stereo pair of channels. So maybe my 3 and 4 is a pair of stereo channels. Then I just want to have one rack with the pair of stereo channels. So then what I would do is I would go and select on my rack 3, I would go stereo, and then I would go find my channel 3 and 4, just like that. And that way now this rack has turned into a stereo channel of the rack, and it allows stereo plugins to be put on this stereo set of channels. Now, it automatically will route the output down here. So we can see that the output is routed to mono output one for the DM3. And so at this point, if I talk into this microphone, we can see that there's channel level here. But if I go and mute this, it's not muting in the console because my patch is still set on my local input. Now, this is where we need to talk about channel gain. This is where you need to set your channel gain at first. So first things first is when you get your band going and everything set up, you need to set your channel gain first, because the only place that you can adjust that channel gain is if your input is assigned to that channel. So if I go and select my USB 1, this is now coming from Waves, but I have a digital gain. This is a digital trim off of the level that's coming from Waves SuperRack Performer, not a gain adjustment to the input of where this is coming from. So if you're looking at Waves SuperRack Performer and one of these meters is getting into the clipping range, you will need to go and patch your input, adjust your gain down, and then change it back to be USB. So at this point, my channel one is going into Waves from my input one, being processed through Waves, going back into the USB, and then on my console is acting as USB input one. And so we can see, check, if I go and mute this, we will have that go away. And if I unmute it, check one, two. And so this is a great way of testing to see if Waves SuperRack Performer is actually in line with your console. So the trick about doing this is set all of your gains, get all of your routing set. So I would go through and route the rest of my channels. So mono channel two, and then we have 3 and 4 set. So we can jump over here to input 5 and so on and so forth until we get all of our channels. At this point, there is a one touch button that we can go and press to change all of our channels to be over to USB. And this is great. You can go hit the gear icon, go to patch, and swing this little out. Once we go to input, we can swing this little side thing out and we can go all USB. And once we click this and press OK, channels 1 through 16 are now coming from our USB, which is great. And then if you need to go adjust channel gains on everything again, you could go back to all input. And then now all of our channels are back to the input. Now you can adjust your gain, swipe this out, go to all USB, press OK, and then we're back over to everything through Waves. Now, I mentioned at the beginning of this video that I'm going to promise to tell you how to get your main stereo left-right bus processing through Waves and back to your console. Now, to do this, we need to burn two sets of channels. One is I need to burn my stereo input. Now, if you are using your stereo input, you could burn one of your effects returns if you want to. And then the other thing that we need to do is we need to use our matrix 1 and 2 to be the actual output to our PA rather than a stereo left right. So the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to set up the matrix section first. So I'm going to go and close out of my patch and go to my bus setup. I'm going to take my matrix 1 and 2 and make them stereo and press link on the pan link. I'm then going to close out of this and go to my patch and change my output patch for my Omni out 7 and 8 to come from my matrix section. So at this point, I'm going to go and select my stereo left or my Omni 7 and pull from matrix 1. And then my Omni 8 is going to be from matrix 2. At this point, we need to go to our outputs and make sure that matrix 1 and 2 are turned up to 0. Now, our default routing with the USB is to send our stereo left right out to waves on 17 and 18. So by default, if you go into your Waves SuperRack Performer, I like to go into my second layer here and opening up right here, and we'll go and select channel 17 and 18 as stereo. Now, if I grab this microphone and start talking, check, 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 we can see that we have metering on our DM7, and we can see that we have metering here, but it's not coming back to our console. You can't hear this. So what we need to do is we need to have a place for waves to come back into our console and then go and output to our matrix section. Now, this is where I go over to my effects mon fader bank and use my stereo channel, or I can use my effects channel. And either way, the routing is still the same. So if we went to go use my effects return, I can go and select my effects return, and I would want to route this from USB 17 and then press one more time to get to right and route it from USB 18. But in this case, I'm going to use my stereo channel. So I'm going to select my stereo channel on stereo in left, and I'm going to select 17, and then I'm going to select it one more time to get to my right and select stereo 18. Now, we need to do a couple more things before we turn this up, because if we turn this up, it would create a feedback loop, which is bad. So I'm going to X out of this, and then I'm going to go to my playback channel, and I'm going to scroll all the way to the bottom and make sure that this is turned off of stereo. And I already had it turned off for some reason. But we need to make sure that stereo is turned off, because we don't want this fader to go to our stereo bus, because that would create a feedback loop. At this point, we need to send this to our matrix section. So we can go and click into here. And if we're viewing our mixes, you just click and drag to the right. And at this point, we can turn this up to 0. So I'm adjusting my stereo in up to 0 into my matrix section. And at this point, we can hear this microphone. So
check, check, check. And if I go to my Waves SuperRack Performer and I press mute,
it is now muted through my PA.
And so at this point,
my stereo left-right bus is being processed through Waves, being sent out 17 and 18 back into my console, going into my stereo input on my stereo channel, and then being sent directly to my matrix section, which is then being sent out to the PA. So at this point, I could go and put a bunch of different plugins. So for instance, I could put in a dynamics of an L2, or I could use the tracked plugin. If I wanted to use a little bit of EQ on my main PA, I could go ahead and add that. So now we can see that I have my Waves L2, and here's my tracked plugin that we could go sync up with Smart to do some quick tuning. Now, by doing this, we not only have all of our 16 channels going into Waves and being processed, being sent to our stereo left right, and then our stereo left right is being sent to Waves, and then being sent back into our console on our stereo in, which is being sent to our matrix section and then out to the PA. Now, one tip that I have for you is, as you're adding plugins into Waves, make sure that you are selecting plugins that have low latency. You don't want to add in a plugin with a lot of latency, because it's just going to take your mix and delay it more and more. And at some point, you're going to hear a doubling effect between your kick drum being hit on stage and you actually hearing it through your PA. So just be careful and use plugins that have very low latency in them. And one way to check that is in Waves SuperRack Performer, we can see how much samples right here is being added by using this plugin. So we can see that the L2 is adding 64 samples of latency. Now, I hope this video was helpful for you today. If you do happen to have any questions, or there's a video that you're hoping I would make on Waves or the Yamaha products, or really any of the other production products that are out there, please post that comment in the comment section down below, as I'm always reading through those comments to find videos that are going to be helpful for you. If you haven't already, make sure to check out my website at drewbrashler.com. Otherwise, I hope you have a great day.